the day's other news, Republicans can now claim a 50th seat in the U.S. Senate. The Associated Press declared Dan Sullivan the winner in his reelection bid in Alaska. Senate control now hinges, as we've been reporting, on January runoffs for two seats in Georgia. The AP also projects that Democrats will control the House of Representatives, but with a smaller majority. Republicans could gain a dozen seats there. Facebook now says that its ban on political ads will likely last another month. It originally covered only the week after the election. The ban is meant to limit misinformation about the presidential results and about those Senate runoffs in Georgia. COVID-19 infections across the U.S. hit more records today. The nation recorded nearly 140,000 new cases in just the last 24 hours, with nearly 62,000 people hospitalized with the virus. In response, more states announced curbs, including New York and Indiana, where Mayor Eric Holcomb said that hospital workers need help.
They're exhausted and overwhelmed and need us all to do the things that we can on the outside that will slow the number of patients that need hospitalization and their treatment inside.
I meant to say Governor Eric Holcomb of Indiana. Deaths are also rising, with more than 1,400 deaths reported on Tuesday alone. Tropical Storm Eta headed today toward a second strike at Florida, this time north of Tampa Bay. It briefly regained hurricane strength before weakening again. High winds and heavy rain struck the coast all day as the storm moved closer. Conditions forced a major bridge and the Tampa International Airport to close. In Hong Kong, pro-democracy lawmakers have announced that they are resigning in a sweeping act of protest. The 15 legislators acted after four of their colleagues were dismissed from the city assembly. Their ouster is part of mainland China's efforts to curb dissent in the semi-autonomous territory. We'll hear more on this later in the program. Pope Francis is pledging again to eradicate sexual abuse by Roman Catholic clergy. His renewed promise today followed an investigation of ex-Cardinal Theodore McCarrick. It found that McCarrick's misconduct went ignored for decades. The Pope read a statement at the Vatican.
Yesterday, the report about the painful case of ex-Cardinal Theodore McCarrick was published. I renew my closeness to the victims of every abuse and the commitment of the Church to uproot this evil.
Francis also spoke in praise of Pope John Paul II today. The Vatican investigation concluded that John Paul knew of McCarrick's misdeeds and made him Archbishop of Washington, D.C. anyway. And back in this country, Wall Street worried about new coronavirus restrictions on businesses, and that held back the broader market. The Dow Jones Industrial Average lost 23 points to close at 29,397. But the NASDAQ rose 232 points, with tech stocks rebounding, and the S&P 500 added 27. Still to come on the NewsHour, COVID-19 continues to take a devastating toll on essential farm workers. The Chinese government jettisons the remaining pro-democracy legislators from Hong Kong. And a young Mississippi guitarist keeps the tradition of the blues alive.
This is the PBS NewsHour from WETA Studios in Washington and in the West from the Walter Cronkite School of Journalism at Arizona State University.